Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to do our fourth and final part of our data series. We are going to learn a little bit about Power Query. Power Query is a tool inside Excel that will allow you to connect multiple data sources from a CSV or an Access database or a text file or even another Excel spreadsheet. You can append information from one source to another, and you can also merge information together. So we are going to go over both of these options today within Power Query. One of the sources we are going to pull in is the CSV that we have been using for the last few lessons. This one has an additional field called expenses, and we'll see how that comes into play. In our Access database, we are going to be using this table that we have been using up until now that's keeping track of sales, as well as our salesmen, and we now have some new information about them, such as what is their annual salary, their state, and their phone number. So we're going to use this information and link it all together using Power Query. So here's my Excel spreadsheet. I have already made data connections in here. The two from Access are on the left. The first one is the sales data, and the second one is the information about salespeople. But over here on the right, I've also brought in data from our CSV file, and you can notice right here that this expenses column is new and it doesn't exist in our previous one. My CSV has a different date range than the data I have from Access. So first, it would be nice if there was a quick way to put all of the CSV data into the data from Access and have one consolidation of all of that data. So how do I do that? If I go over to the data menu and I go to get data, there's an option down here called Launch Power Query Editor. I'm going to launch that for a minute and then I'm going to explain a couple of the things that come up inside of Power Query. If I look on the left, I will see sales, salesmen, and sales two. I'm going to close Power Query for a minute so that I can explain what those are. If I go up to queries and connections, I will see sales, salesmen, and sales two. If I hover over each one, I can see a little bit of my data. So if I look at sales, I see there's an ID, then a date. I know that that is my sales data coming from Access. If I hover over my salesmen, you can see that this matches this. That's the query for this data source. And down here, I can see the dates coming in and they're all in August and their sales data. That matches with my data right here from CSV. So a query in this case is data that I have obtained from another source. It looks like an Excel table, but for purposes of what we're doing today, we're going to call it a query. So remember, sales relates to the sales data from Access, salesmen is the salesmen from Access, and sales parentheses two is what we are pulling in from our CSV. The first thing I would like to do with my data is take my CSV data and append it to my Access data. Look here, you can see that most of the fields are similar except for the expenses field in the CSV. We will work out that issue in a minute. So if I want to append the CSV to Access, I would go over here on the data ribbon to get data, and then I would go down to combine queries and go to append. First, I will be asked how many tables do I want to append to each other. I only want to do two tables in this case. The first one will be sales and the second one will be sales two. And then I'm going to click OK. Power Query will automatically be launched. If you look on the screen, you will see that up top is my Access data. And then if I scroll down, you will see my CSV data appended at the bottom, which is exactly what I want to do. I would like to keep this data, so I'm going to hit Close and Load. And my data has now been loaded to a new tab called Append 1. And if you look over here on the right, Append 1 has become another query that I can use inside of my workbook. So if I scroll down, you can see my data has come in. My date formatting is a little off. We will fix that later on. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to get notifications of our new weekly Excel tips. So now that I have my append query, if I look back, it would be nice to bring in some information about my salespeople, maybe their phone number and their salary. So let's see how we would do that. I'm going to go back to the data ribbon, go to get data, go to combine queries, and this time I'm going to hit merge. Excel is asking me what the first source I would like to merge is. I would actually like to merge the appending that I just did because I want all of my data to come together in one place. So I'm going to pick append one. And the second table that I'm going to pick this time is going to be salesmen. And I would like to match these two tables on the field, salesperson and first name, because that's where my salesman name is located. And I have different options for a join. I'm just going to keep the default and then I'm going to click OK. And now if I look in here, last time rows were added to the bottom of my data set down here. But if I look up here, I will see salesman with this icon right here. I'm going to click on that icon and I can add all the fields from my new table and I'm going to click OK. And now the salesperson's name is coming in as well as their salary and the state that they're from and their phone number. This is exactly what I want. So I'm going to hit close and load. And I now have a new tab called merge one, because this time we've merged the data instead of appending it. So when I look to the right, I can see that this was Jim. This also was Jim. This was Andy. This also was Andy. And now I can see the other information that's being brought in. And that is now a new query over here called merge one. I'm going to close this window for now. So some of this data I want and some of this data I don't want. So how can I edit that? I'm going to go back to data and go to launch Power Query Editor and make sure I'm selecting merge one. Now I'm going to go up here where I can choose my columns. I'm going to hit choose columns, and I really don't want to see all of these columns. I don't want to see this blank one. I don't want to see this ID that comes out of access, but I would like to see the date and the salesperson, but the salesperson's showing up twice. I'm going to take it off down here. The state where the sale was made, the amount sold, and all the numbers I would like to see. Also the salary and the state that the salesperson is from and their phone number. So if I click OK, I can now see that my data has been consolidated into just those fields that I want. So I'm going to hit close and load again. And you will see that my merged data has become just those columns that I wanted to select. So for now, I can go in here with my dates and format those correctly. I can click in all of my money columns right here, and I can make those currency. And now there's a couple issues here. First of all, there were expenses that were found in the CSV file, but they were not found in the Access table. So you could go in and manually enter those for the missing ones in Microsoft Access. Another thing I can do is I can add some columns out here. Say I had some logic that if I make $65,000 a year, I get 10% of the profits in a commission. But if I make $50,000, I get 15% of the commissions of each sale. So remember the IFS function? If I type equals IFS with a left parenthesis, I want to know if this column equals $65,000, then I'm going to return this times 0.1, and then I'm going to type a comma for my second logical test that if this cell equals $50,000, then I'm going to return the profit times 0.15. Then I'm going to hit enter and I can see what my commission is. In this case, I am returning 10% because this is 65,000. But in this case, I am returning 15% because this is 50,000. It's a way to give the people making less of a salary a way to catch up with more sales. I can rename this column commission, and I can also do other calculations now that I have tied all of this data together. So in review today, we went over what is actually a query inside of Microsoft Excel. And we usually like to think of them as a table, but for the purposes of Power Query, they're each called a query. We went over different ways to combine queries, whether or not it was merging or appending. And then we saw how we could tie all of our data together. Hopefully you learned something new today and check back next week. We will have a brand new series. Thanks for watching and see you again soon.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions, and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.